Well. Chao, so estamos un pequeño breakecito y ahorita vamos a buscar algo de comer. Obviamente nadie quiere comer lo que ofrece la unidad porque son unas comidas rarísimas. Hay un Subway cerca, hay un Burger King, hay comidas rápidas, pero creo que voy a comer algo de lo más seguro Subway. Ok, so ya tenemos una ensaladita deliciosa y esta ensalada la vamos a acompañar con un café. Yo, chavo, lo puedo dejar con este, es uno de los vehículos que manejamos, es un PLS. Y es un vehículo que se carga y se descarga solo. Está con Alarmy desde 1993. So, esto fue una explicación de cómo se maneja y cómo funcionan los controles en la cabina de PLS. Está en inglés, pero seguro lo van a entender. Así que aquí se lo dejo para que lo disfruten y aprendan un poquitito de lo que hacemos aquí con el Army National Guard. So, este vehículo entró al servicio en 1993. Es básicamente una unidad táctica especializada en traer suplementos, todo lo que es munición, todo lo que son alimentos a las tropas en combate y de forma local también. El tipo de carga principal son los contenedores. Es un vehículo de 10 ruedas que lo utiliza Estados Unidos, pero también lo utiliza Israel, Jordania y Turquía. Diseñado por la compañía Oshkosh Corporation desde 1989. Se diseñó en el 89, pero comenzó a ser producido hasta 1992 y hasta ahora que se sigue produciendo. Hay cuatro variaciones, el M1074A0, M1075A0, M1074A1 y el M1075A1. Tiene un peso de 24.040 kilogramos y pues con un flat, una cama pesaría 39.000 kilogramos. En total sería un 61.462 kilogramos. Tiene 10.79 metros de largo, con 2.5 metros de ancho. Tiene una altura de 3.27 metros, que vendrían siendo alrededor de 10 pies con 9 pulgadas. En su interior pueden caber dos personas, está diseñado para dos personas. El motor es un Caterpillar C15, 15.2 litros de 6 cilindros en línea. Es un motor diésel, obviamente, 600 caballos de fuerza, una capacidad de peso de 14.965 kilogramos en un flatbed. Su transmisión es una Allison 4500 SP, 5 velocidades automática, Oshkosh 36000 serie de 2 velocidades la caja de transferencia. Tiene una suspensión Oshkosh TAC 4. Totalmente independiente. La velocidad máxima es de 62 millas por hora, que viene siendo 100 kilómetros básicamente. Así que ahí está. Ese es el PLS, famoso PLS. Super mega utilizado. Nosotros usamos muchísimo este vehículo. Y bueno, les dejo entonces, ahora sí, la explicación que la dio un compañero de cómo funcionan todos los botones y todo el interior del vehículo, para que tengan ustedes una idea y si tienen curiosidad de estos vehículos, pues que aprendan un poquito más. Ahí se los dejo.
Whenever you want to operate the ECU system from outside, make sure the driver has your hydraulic system in auto. That first click is in auto. I know these things are busted a little bit, but now this helps operate the hook, just like in the LHS. But with the hand signals, if you see someone doing this when you first start out to try to get the hook off, that's they're trying to tell you to get the hook up in the air. But really, this means load. This means unload. So they're supposed to be doing this. That way you know to push down.
Okay.
If you see someone doing this and you haven't even just started, like, you have to correct them. But after you correct them, it's like, no, this means that. Just go along with it. Don't start an argument. Just, you already know that you're gonna unload the hook, the crane. That way you can upload the connex. And then of course, this means load. That way you know to push forward to load everything onto the flat rack, or not the flat rack, the truck. Now, this is to start the ignition. You'll sit there, wait for everything to go through, get confirmation, get done configuring everything. Right here is, like I said, the same as the LHS. You have your PSI for both the front and rear, and this is an air brake system. So whenever you hit your air brakes, if you want to go ahead and hit them, and release, they will slowly go down. You see it slowly go down? Now, if this gets below 60 PSI, both front and back, it's going to let the alarm sound off, and it's very annoying. And
so is this the same where you have to put it in neutral and rev it?
Yep, you don't have to. There's a high idle on this right over there. So now, of course, the horn's right here if you want to push it. Right there's the big horn. Right here's your heating and cooling system. Now in the summer,
gets up here like this. Did you honk that horn?
Of course, in the winter, if you try to get on the heating, like trying to get it hot and it doesn't work, just go ahead and annotate it. That way they know to fix it. Same thing with the summertime. If you try to get the cold airflow, go ahead. If it's not working, annotate it. But it's not gonna have it. It will have actually pretty good heat in the wintertime if it works, but in the summertime, it won't have like ice cold airflow. It'll have decent airflow if it works. And like I said, if you, right here's your lights, right here's your blackout lights. You don't have to worry about that. Right here's your cab light, if you want to look back there. Yep.
And these are the hazards.
Yep, these are the hazards that like activate them, push them in, to of course pull them out. Right here's your windshield wipers, all that fun stuff. Your turn signal. Actually, no, your windshield wipers are right over there. Yep. That's to wash them, and right there's your windshield wipers right next to them to get the speed going. And if you want, push that to start. Oh, yeah, hold it. There you go. Now, if you want to tap that, it throws in high idle.
This?
Yep.
Hit it?
Yep. So that's high idle. It's going to take it up to 15 RPMs, and it'll stay there. That helps build air faster, and like, some people love to just put their foot to the floor with it, but you can completely blow out the engine that way. One good thing about these is, like, that's probably going too, if you tell me. But, like I said, you always want to have your lights on. This is where they're on, this is where they're fully on. And that's when your partner, BMCS, will sit there and check the lights, they'll tell you. Instead of hitting the turn signal left and right when they tell you, just go ahead and throw on your hazards. That'll hit perfectly. Front and back. And even with your blinkers on, if you push the brake, they'll sit there until you hit the brake. Just tap it a few times and it will show. Do you have any other questions?
No.
All right. One, just go ahead and hit that. Then shut her off. Make sure your hazards are off. Make sure your lights are off.
Get the pedal. Yep. I ain't going
make sure this is off as well before you turn her off, but we already shut her off.
Okay.
That's basically the.
All right, so I got the top. At this point, I'm going to back up, and then these bottoms will feed right into the connex. Now, I know it's the yellow car that's kind of falling for me to run around. While that machine is operating, moving, this right here, never get between a truck and the connex. That's a pinch point, and good God. Pinch point.
que Jenny y yo tenemos un dilema porque estamos en un steakhouse japonés y vinimos a comer hibachi, right? Vinimos a comer hibachi y sushi. Pero les quiero enseñar algo. Si ustedes observan, aquí al fondo, tienen que seguir este tipo. Ahorita les voy a enseñar algo. Al fondo, donde está el sushi bar, si ustedes se dan cuenta, vamos a ver. Vamos a observar a la gente que trabaja en el sushi bar, que son esos que están ahí atrás. Si se dan cuenta de toda esta gente que trabaja en el sushi bar, este chamaco que está acá, espérame, este que está acá, el último. Les voy a enseñar. Aguántense. Aguántense. Este que está acá, el último, vean. Ese no se ve tan japonés que digamos. Ese más parece más hondureño que otra cosa. Vean, eso no es japonés para nada.